And excuse us as we break in again. We want to continue to update the breaking news that we mentioned earlier today of a plane down in Brookfield, Capital Airport. You can see it there upside down. Matt Salemi in the air. Matt, first reports of an ultralight. This looks more like a small plane, is it?
It looks more like an experimental aircraft, one that would be a home-built aircraft, Jason. That's what I would say just from the first glance, not until they get it turned upside right, though. But definitely does not look like an ultralight. I would say you're correct in that. You can see authorities are combing around the area, and if you look close at the tires, it looks like he tried to make an emergency landing. And because he's landing in a marshy area here, where his tires hit down, just sunk right into the swamp water and flipped it over on its upside down. And right now it looks like they're working to get somebody out of there. At this point, we don't have a report on how many people were inside of the craft, but it looks like they're going to begin to try and possibly flip it over at this point. Now, I can tell you that just a short distance from here, the sitting on the runway is all the emergency equipment. There is a couple of ambulances, a couple of fire trucks, and a couple of Brookfield Police Department personnel here. And at this point, it's hard to tell if they got anybody out of this yet or not, but you can see the badly damaged aircraft is still upside down. Now, let's widen out just a little bit here, and we'll show you where those crews are standing by. Right over here, they have a couple of other aircraft as well. It looks like somebody taxied down the runway at one point trying to come over to it to get to the crash site. As you can see, there's quite a bit of swamp and marsh between the area where the emergency crews are set up and where the ultralight flipped over in the swampy marsh area. But we are still trying to gather some information. We have crews en route on the ground to try and ask some questions and get some more details for you. Jason?
Hey, Matt, you take off from Timmerman. Compare Timmerman to Capital and the type of traffic they get into that type of airport.
Well, it's a lot slower than Timmerman. It's an uncontrolled airport, so there's no air traffic control tower. They have one grass runway and one paved runway. And right now the winds are out of the southeast. We took off out of the southeast. At least that's what they were at Timmerman. So he would have been using the grass runway, which is a little bit south of where he ended up in the marsh. So at this point, it's hard to tell exactly what he was doing, but you can see the grass runway also a good distance away from where he was. But the winds, again, would have favored using that grass strip as opposed to the paved strip at this point. And you can see where he ended up. And we are now getting reports that Trauma 1, Flight for Life, is on the way here, circling to land at the airport at this point.
We had gotten a report earlier of some ATVs maybe trying to make their way out there. I guess this may be a needle in a haystack kind of thing, trying to find a small plane out there. Give us an idea. We see people on foot, but you also said on the runway, a good amount of emergency crews there as well, sort of standing by if they need to get out, which has to be difficult, I'm guessing.
You can imagine standing at ground level, you can see the reeds in the marsh area are up to the shoulder of the personnel going. So if you're standing you know, a quarter mile of away, which is where about they are on the paved runway here, and trying to look, it'd be difficult to see through the reeds if the because the aircraft did flatten. Now here we see Flight for Life coming in below us, getting ready to find a safe spot to land to take anybody that may be injured away from this crash site. So yeah, it definitely could be difficult to see spot originally from the ground if you didn't actually see where it went in, Jason.
And this is a small, uncontrolled airport, Capital Airport. Word coming in early that it could have been an ultralight. Now it's looking more like a small plane that went down. As Matt was showing us, throughout that marsh area, there were some areas where it looked like the wheels kind of dug in this emergency landing attempt, perhaps, to save what they could, salvage what they could in the crash. Still unclear of how many people may be on board and what injuries may be, but we did just see Flight for Life fly in, as Matt said, looking for a safe place to land. Matt, I'm guessing with a helicopter coming in, Flight for Life, this could signal possible injuries to the people on board.
That's affirmative. Flight for Life wouldn't, you know, if there was a fatality, it would have to be handled by the coroner's office. They don't transport anybody unless they're you know, savable at this point. So right now you can see there is plenty of emergency equipment here on scene. They've had to make quite a hike through the swamp area to get back to where the aircraft is sitting, where the crash landing occurred. And now you can see they're trying to flip it upright to try to get a better assessment of exactly how much damage was done. Unsure at this point how many people were on board of this experimental aircraft, but you can see emergency personnel trying to get under there. Looks like somebody crawling out from underneath there right now as they've been able to lift it up. Again, you can see that the reeds are caught up in the wheels of the aircraft, so they may have been attempting to make an emergency landing, but because you can see how swampy the tread marks are where they did crash land, that it just flipped flipped right over once the wheels touched the ground and basically put him upside down in swamp water. Looks like one person has made it out successfully. A little wobbly there in the aqua shirt. Looks like there may be one more person on board at this point. Hard to tell exactly with the low wing being obscuring where they are working at this point. But it looks like at least one person out safely at this point, and they appear to be walking around at their own power.
Good news out there. Hey, Matt, one more time for people who don't understand uncontrolled airport. Pilots sort of guide their way in and out, and they're sort of looking out for each other, I'm guessing, and that could have signaled to police. Perhaps another pilot may have spotted this plane. What's the situation like when it is uncontrolled?
Well, it's as you mentioned, the pilots, they use the radio, a common radio frequency, and they would announce their intentions before they make any maneuvers. So this person may have been landing or departing here at Capital Airport, and maybe another party getting ready to take off here actually witnessed the crash. That may have been the reason that they were able to see exactly what happened, because you can see there is another aircraft here on the runway, and they may have taxied over to try and help before the emergency personnel arrived. But as you can see, quite a challenge to get yourself out through that marshland, about between an eighth and a quarter of a mile of a hike through high reeds. They're about shoulder height for the emergency personnel arriving on the scene. So quite a difficult task making the rescue.
Sure, and again, this is the big shot now. We were able to see at least one person make their way. Said the gentleman, I can't make it out on my screen, an aqua shirt making their way out, but still a lot of eyeballs on that airplane. Thanks for zooming in. Now I got a better look at it. So now the work is to make sure that no one else is in there or injured, perhaps. Let's talk about the aircraft again. And you mentioned something for people who may not know experimental aircrafts. For some folks, this is a hobby, maybe in your own garage, working on an airplane. Talk about the system that goes through making an airplane like this.
Well, that's the difference of it, is it doesn't come from an airplane manufacturer. An experimental aircraft would be one that would be somebody would have home built or built at the hangar out here at the airport. So you're right, it is a hobby for many to actually build it themselves, and there's a satisfaction that comes with that, and also risk if you if it's not properly maintained, that you could have a problem. As with any aircraft, they have to keep proper maintenance on it, and we're not sure that that was the case here, but oftentimes when the emergency landing is required, it's because something has malfunctioned along the way.
What was your last sight of Flight for Life, Matt? Does it look like they are going to land here and possibly help someone out? We hadn't seen the helicopter since it whizzed through a couple seconds ago. Have they landed?
I have not seen, because we've been focusing in on the crash site, Jason.
Sure.
I haven't seen where they ended up, but it's hard for me to ascertain on the tight zoom here. But they wouldn't have landed in the marsh area, because it's just not safe. As you can see, the reeds are high and very swampy. You wouldn't want to have one skid get caught when you're trying to take off in the mud and swamp water. So I can't exactly see them at this point.
Sure, and we'll walk folks through again if you're just joining us. This call came in sometime this afternoon, about 1:30, of a plane down. The first call came in, it was thought this may be an ultralight aircraft, and this is where it all occurred. It's the Capitol Drive Airport, if you're unfamiliar, in the Brookfield area. We did see another plane on the runway, unclear of where the initial call came in, but we did hear that maybe the pilot on board was radioing that there may have been some distress. As we got our helicopter in the air, you're able to see some tracks throughout that marsh area, soft marsh area, where it may have been an emergency landing. You can see it leading up to the aircraft. What was interesting in those first pictures is that it's clear that that plane is upside down. Upon closer inspection, you can tell that it might be an experimental aircraft, something that someone makes themselves, like Matt said, not by a manufacturer. And then the tough part, making their way out into that marshy area to somehow get to the plane, and now getting the folks on board, unclear of the number, off the plane and getting them some help. A few minutes ago, as we got on the air, we did see a Flight for Life helicopter fly through, and you see it there again making its way around. Matt was saying, Matt, and correct me if I'm wrong, they may be looking for a safe and maybe hard surface to put that aircraft down and maybe help someone in need of help.
That's exactly correct, Jason. They wouldn't want to put it down in the marsh because they wouldn't want to risk their equipment. You know, once the weight of the aircraft settles in that marsh, it could sink down into the mud, and then they would have a difficult time launching once again. So they're circling right now. They may also be ascertaining if it's actually necessary. If the we saw the person climb out of there, and they looked a little wobbly, but they appeared to be walking under their own power at the time. So maybe they are reassessing whether the Flight for Life trip to the airport is, or back to the hospital, is necessary at this point. But they are still circling low around the crash site itself.
And not to discount the work they're doing on the ground right now, but from all appearances, It's a slow operation. You don't see a hurried rush around the aircraft. Perhaps a good sign. We don't know right now. But as you said, helicopter circling, hoping to get some more information on who may be on board. Again, if you're just joining us, this is Capital Airport. We're live right now taking a look at a small plane that went down this afternoon just after 1 o'clock. You can see people around that aircraft, and just in front of them, you'll notice that some of that grass is laid down. It's believed that that could possibly be part of a crash landing, emergency landing, to get the plane on the ground. If we're able to, Matt, and I'm sorry to make you to work hard up there, but if you can widen out a little bit, we'll give folks an idea of how far away the aircraft is from the runway. There are two out there. There's one that's a concrete landing strip you see on the left. There's also a grass landing strip as well. Unclear of which one that plane was attempting to land on, but you can see not that far away. The difficulty is the area that they're in right now, a soft area where you can't get any heavy equipment out to the aircraft, but you can see on foot a number of emergency personnel in their gear. I'm just going to try to get a look at what exactly they may be doing. They're rounding up their gear now. We did see one person in an aqua shirt, you're saying, made their way off of the aircraft. Unclear of anyone else on board. This is an experimental airplane at an uncontrolled airport where I guess pilots sort of look out for each other. There's a real fraternity of pilots, yeah?
That's exactly right. The pilots are always careful to radio their before they make any maneuvers. They would call out on a common radio frequency and announce what they are about to do. They're about to partake, and as you can see, they also carried a stretcher out there. We can now see as they're pulling it out of the reeds, Jason, so it looks like they were ready to make a transport across the swamp. We've got some straps to drag it through the swamp marsh area, but it looks like the person on board are going to be able to make the walk themselves at this point.
Sure.
Emergency crew still speaking with, I believe I saw the person in the aqua shirt there leaning up against the wing when they lifted it up. Again, a precarious situation because of where they landed in the marsh water. It looks like they touched down initially right side up, but the wheels immediately into the swamp water, and the way that they're lined up, it looks like they were trying to get it back into the wind, because the winds are out of the southeast here, which would line up with roughly about the direction that those skid marks are pointing.
Hey, Matt, an experimental aircraft and an ultralight. I'm guessing from the title alone, ultralight is probably a far lightweight aircraft. For something like this, they're getting straps to pull it out. I mean, would you need heavy equipment to get something like this out? I mean, would this be comparable to like a Cessna kind of plane?
Well, it's much lighter than a Cessna. You saw the six or seven emergency person on scene were able to lift the whole thing up so that the persons on board could climb out. So it's lighter than what a Cessna would be. And the difference is that a Cessna's manufactured at a plant, and the experimental aircraft are manufactured. They're a home-built type aircraft. I'd like to be more of a much smaller, more like a hang glider with a go-kart underneath it is about the description I would put on an ultralight. So this is a little bit bigger than that and a little bit smaller than your average training aircraft.
All right, Matt. Well, thank you for your service up there this afternoon. Again, this is a small plane crash, Capital Airport. There's a look of where that is in the Brookfield area. 12 News' Nick Bohr on the ground now. We'll have reports from him at 5 o'clock this afternoon. We'll also update this story online, Facebook and Twitter, as we always do. You'll be able to find more details throughout the evening. Sorry for breaking in. We'll update the story throughout the day.